This week is our week of what? As our week of graduation. It means we are living or moving from one level into another level. You didn't hear what I said. I said you are moving from one level into another level. Your level is changing. Amen. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard. So God believe in standard. Amen. That you will not be a mediocre Christian. Amen. That in every aspect of your life, you experience the glory of God. Let me hear all of this. Amen. So God has already set the standard for your life, that your life will not be compared to an unbeliever. Every child of God is like a tree. Is comparing to like a tree that has been planted. Amen. So you are not like unbeliever that have been buried, but you have been planted. And you have been planted in a good soil. Amen. You have been planted in where? In the good soil. You have been planted in Christ Jesus. Everyone that is planted in Christ Jesus is living a meaningful life. Give the Lord a mighty clap offering. Wini bibi mame kansi minchiro. Adibia o nyankopon ehye hu bobia. Ohye ebo ewo nasim. Praise God. Every promises of God is connected to his word. Onipa bia onim nyankopon asem bia onim nhyira kwan. There are men of God that are promising testimonies and blessings and breakthrough. Listen to me very careful. Me see onyankopon ne boshe nyina wona semu de boshe wehe adibie nyankopon she ho bo wo wo life biara is connected to his word. More now unya revelation, your life transform. Me who be our mature will grow. Why you blessed without God's word? And you see, Adibiara in Ninyakopansi will be any more. One can make a cry. Satan is wrong. How long you fast and pray? Unsure who lay hands on you. Listen to me very careful. How long you fast and pray? Because Jesus Christ fasted for 40 days and Satan was still there. He fasted for, you see, let me tell you something. He fasted for 40 days, Jesus Christ. I'm not talking about your pastor. I'm talking about Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of your faith. He fasted for 40 days and Satan was still there to tempt him. Praise God. So the enemy is not afraid of our fasting, but he's afraid of the level of God's word in you. The level of revelation you receive while you are fasting. Lift your right hand, let me hear all of this. Amen. The long hour prayer without God's word cannot scare the enemy. Can I repeat myself? The disciples were casting out devils. disciples. They tried to cast out devil from one little girl, and they did it from morning to evening, and Jesus appeared. Jesus appeared. Jesus appeared. And he said, because you lack faith. So it is possible for you to pray from morning to evening without result. Lift up right and let me hear this. I said, it is morning. We are fasting and we are praying, and we are also being careful not to pray amiss. Listen to me very careful. That every prayer we pray here must be answered by God. I was saying, I'm going to pray for you. Because you're not going to pray for you. But you're going to pray for you. You're going to pray outside God's way. Your bomb pie, when you come once more. A pie beer, your bomb when you come once more, be a result only a positive. Oh, come on, come and catch a part. I see God touching somebody's life today. According to the book of Hebrews, chapter number 11 verse 3. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 3. Hear what the Bible says. Hear what the Bible says. He said, through faith, through faith, we understand that the world were framed by the word of God. In other words, the world was created. The world and everything in this world was created in praise God. So the miracle you are chasing is in the word of God. The breakthrough you are chasing is in the word of God. Praise God. All wrong testimonies are connected to God's word. Period. So as you grow your prayer life, you must also grow the level of God's word in you. So in this fasting, don't only concentrate on prayer, but you must also concentrate on the word of God. Can I hear your others say amen? Make sure you don't receive a call. He said that through faith, we understand that the world were framed by the word of God. He said, so that things which are seen, now listen to this, things, everything we are seeing, were not made of things which do appear. So everything was in the word. Praise God. So as we fast and also praying, may God help you to grow the level of your revelation. Praise God. Ask the Holy Spirit to grow the level of your revelation. According to the book of John chapter 1, very popular scripture, John chapter 1. You see, let me tell you, we've been praying from Sunday to today, and I have not preached. So the Spirit of the Lord ministered to me to preach to you today. So listen to me very careful. It means that God wants to do something new in your life. Can I hear your loudest amen? John chapter 1, he said, let me read from 1, then you understand me very careful. He said, in the beginning was the word. In the beginning In the beginning of everything was the Word. So God laid the foundation of everything he has created by the Word. Amen. So that's the reason why the foundation of your life, the foundation of your life, your mission, and Adibia Nyankopon are promising your life, we are laid the foundation of God's Word. Lift your right hand, let me all others, amen. There are many people that whenever we talk about blessing, they look at cars, they look at the house, they look at, let me tell you, me won minimum crop four months are dying, pain, and you want more pain, but today their children are beggars. If you don't know, Adibia nipen nyabu nyankopon wa simuda, you are likely to lose. So put that one in your mind. You are likely to lose. Kadiba Sataya. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And what? Let's read it. And the Word, God. Out of nothing was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word itself was what? So whenever God's Word find a place in one's life or one's heart, what does it mean? It means God is at work in the heart and in the life of that person. Asem Yankopon asem. But what you say? Nyankopon asem ye diebe. Eye nyankopon. Eti, onipe bi nyankopon asem, eye juma unimu biara. Automatically, nyamene eye juma unimu. Verse 2. The same was in the beginning with God. 3. All things, now hear this one. All things were made by him. By who? By who? Everything was made by? Everything wasn't made by your prophet and his prophecy. Praise God. But everything was made by. So go for the Word. Say, when you respect a nyankopon woman, you will not play with the Word of God. When you respect, right? You see, there are many of you that have no respect for the Word of God. And I'm telling you, God has no respect for you. Praise God. Okoye of us to treat Nyankopon asem, respect Nyankopon, and regard Nyankopon asem, honor Nyankopon asem, is the same way that God will honor you. Your amen look like you didn't hear what I said. Is the same way that God will honor you. Because with him, asem no ye nyankopon nti, nyame ene nasem eyepe. Did you hear what I said? Praise God. Nyame nasem. Yes. O nyankopon ne nasem ye den eyepe pepe. It will fa nyame asem awa fa den. Afi nyankopon. Otu nyame asem kene a, otu nyame a kene. Oh God, help us. And he said, and without him, now look at it. And without him was anything made that was without God's word. What can't you Bible not say? Nyankopon wa nkwati anye bibia. But there are many of you that think that Nyankopon de nasembe to nche yeshira wo. Nyankopon de nasembe to nche na wasawiade. Nyame de nasembe to nche no amwa break through. Nyame de nasembe. No, it's not working like that. Go for the word. Everything you are chasing and believing God for is in the word of God. Give God a mighty clap offering. Give God a mighty clap offering. Praise God. Look at it. Ebra, Satan also Yesu when he quoted a scripture. With him, sir. What shall I say? Fisura neja una koto fisura. What shall I say? Obema na bofa be di ebe. Yeah. So even Satan tried to quote a scripture, but you know what he did? He quoted a scripture without the leading of the Spirit and without revelation, and it was out of context. It was scripture. It is God's word, but he turned the word outside down. Praise God. And Jesus represents the epitome of the word. He represents the word of God. Praise God. Full of wisdom and understanding. He represents the word of God, full of wisdom and understanding. That though Satan quoted the scripture, he quoted scripture at the wrong time. And Jesus knew what to do. Praise God. It means that whenever the enemy, maybe a Satan be meeting the enemy measures you by the level of his word. Of the word of God. That's how the enemy measures you. He valued you by the level of your word. He killed him. Say, Satan, maybe you're in crowd form, you're full of God's word. He become confused. Can I hear that? This amen. Can I hear that? This amen. Because he knows that he cannot redirect them. He cannot change their destiny. He cannot change their focus. I'm preaching good. I'm preaching good. He can't change their destiny. He can't reorder their steps. Obi onim nyankopon asem biara oye fully connected to his mission, his vision, and his assignment. Abasata yandala. Can I yell at this amen? Can I yell at this amen? Yes. 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 You see, let me tell you something. The enemy will not take us for granted after we have prayed. So we are growing the level of our way. Faith coming by hearing and by hearing. So the level of faith. Everyone that claims to have faith, I will not deceive himself. Because faith coming by hearing. The level of your faith determined by the level of your way. Praise God. Let me tell you, which way you want? My maker said, "Mister, say we need to be here 3 days, sir. Me who any man me who? Say we need to be here 3 days. If you show up and I want known for be here 3 days, oh, but who be here? Who appearance show? Your face look like. Who 3 weeks crash right? And the confusion at your face, and even now you are walking." Because you have not eaten. Amen. On fire, piani, and fidi. Praise God. But you see, the question is, are you feeding the man that lives in you? The real you is your spirit. Amen. And he grows. He grows. Oh my God. The real you is not this flesh. This flesh is just a container. It's our flesh way. Near man here fine. And maybe I'm confirming some back. I said, why you fine? Be it means where you dear you can see it. Me buana. Why you fine you? Not just why we numb. Where did he? Why you fine? That's okay. But why you fine within Anna? The question is that in the inside of you, are you fine? And I know the young man. Praise God. God goes beyond the flesh and how nice you are looking at physically. He looked inside. Because Jacob on daily with you by this flesh. You can be nice physically, but spiritually many things can be wrong. I'm talking to somebody here. I'm talking to somebody here. You can be nice physically on why you fall, but in the realms of the spirit, and the spirit man that dwelled in you can be messed up. There are many of you for about 3 months now. You can't even remember one or any of your dream. Somebody say, Lord, help me. Say, Holy Spirit, help me to grow my level of revelation. Yes. The enemy sees us as a fool. If we are not walking by God's word. According to the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 15. No problem. You have a vampire. You have a beside the vampire. But take your time. All right. Me name sampai bunti na bae. But me mau key. Every man pipe when I very strong. That's what I'm doing. That's all. I want to help you so when you are praying, you can pray well. That's what I'm doing. We are all like a fool. You have no divine key into your destination without God's word. Write it down if you believe in writing. You have no divine key. Everyone without God's word is like a person that's standing by his door or his gate without the key. Let me tell you, you are not supposed to struggle with the enemy. You are to command the enemy. The word of God is compared to as two-edged sword. When you pray with God's word, when you attack the enemy with God's word, it comes like two-edged sword. I'm telling you. Lift your right hand and shout aloud this amen. Shout it again. Oh, come on, shout it again. Come on, shout it again. Every closing door in your life will begin to open. Look at it. He said, the labor of the foolish, the labor of the foolish. May you never be seen in the eyes of God as a foolish person. Because you see, the fact is that the Almighty God cannot afford to bless foolish people. A person that is foolish cannot receive anything from God. How can I yell at this? Amen. Amen. If you put a blessing in the hand of a foolish person, they will still miss it. A foolish person cannot be healed. A foolish person cannot be blessed. A foolish person cannot have a successful marriage. Yes, that is what it is. You must be wise. You must be wise. You must be wise. The labor of the foolish weareth every one of them. Whenever you see his face, you see foolishness. You see the way he talks, you see foolishness. You see the behavior, he behaves like a foolish person. Momani and now what he said here, Ben. Abuadain. And yes, I know you can. We didn't mean anything. And then thing I used to see me in the house is our war. But you want to be in the enemy. Let me not do the talking alone. I didn't hear. Want to be in Abuami. Please. Yes. Mente. Snake or your vice, very, very wise. Okay, thank you. Mom said, Mom, that is the wisdom side of snake, or a serpent, or a dragon, or whatever you call. But in your walk, because of the other time, say, we bet me on your war after them for 2 years, you will not know. Praise God. When I'm them who are PA, or better wardrobe, or better trunk him, own piano, own PA area, own PA, obey piano, I draw wada, and I draw doubles on Namono muscle, breo, when I am canoe on cow. Praise God. On cow, or before suboco, you may be a dana draw, I want an amy as a you may not know, but it's true. Praise God. Eti Eda ube wuse. Owone jini huni na. Edi agu ude mono. Na tese we yue ne juma oko. Men shusha na. Men shusha owo honse gu obe biya. O niho. Or far away where we in the mission or call. Because on himself when we saw it will be start to say wash. Very smart. Very smart. Or one na more quack a crown who a pigeon it in wash. No a sense in a chis will be bar. Yes. It is Bible see yenye very wise. Ye my nina ho. Praise God. He said that the labor of a foolish weareth every one of them. Because, now look at it. He said, because, let's read it, want to go. Because he knoweth not how to, you are supposed to go to the city. You are graduating from one place to another. You are to go to the city. But with foolishness, you are frustrated. The reason a lot of people are facing setbacks and disappointment and a lack of revelation. And a lack of revelation. Can I hear another amen? And a lack of revelation. You have no access into the next stage of your life without a revelation. Please catch. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Whenever God's word grows in you, it's like a giant has been awake in the inside of you, searching, looking for something to do, something to connect to. Hallelujah. Yes. Listen, you must know how to enter into the city. You must know how to enter the city. You must know how to enter into your own city. You have a city to enter. You have a blessing to possess. You have a place in this life. I'm talking to somebody here. You have a place. You have a land to possess. You have a house to build. You have a man to marry. You have a woman to marry. Lift your right hand, let me hear that. Say amen. But with foolishness, you are disconnected. But with wisdom and revelation, you are connected. So the master key, the master key, the master key, the master key to the next stage of your life is God's word. The master key to the next stage of your life is God's word. Be very careful the way you treat God's word. Be extra careful. According to the book of Isaiah chapter number, Isaiah 26. Yes, Isaiah 26 verse 2. Isaiah 26 verse 2. Let's read it together. One, two, go. Open ye the gate, that the righteous nation which keepeth the truth may enter. Wow! Open what? I mean, open ye the gate. Open ye. The gate have been closed. The gate set as obstacle, hindrance. Praise God. Like invisible barrier. But with God's word, the gate are to open. You will not be frustrated this year, 2021. Why are you looking at me like that? I'm talking about something that's going to happen to you and you are looking at me. I say you will not be frustrated in the year 2021. You still not get what I'm talking about. I said in this year 2021, you will not be frustrated like every ordinary person. Because you know what? You have a master key in your hand. You have a master key. You have every legal ground to prosper, to be lifted out, to change your level, and to move on in life. To buy your property, to own your property, to start your own company. I'm talking to somebody here. You have any legal ground to expand your business, to add more business to what you are doing. Lift your two hands and shout the loudest amen. Shout it again. No way. Shout it again. One more time. One more time. One more time. Open is a command. So let me repeat. Oh my God. In this year, as we fast and pray, together with the revelation we receive every day, wherever you go, you try to enter and other people couldn't enter, you have a glorious key. A golden key, a master key to command the gate to open. Somebody is getting married before the year comes to an end. Somebody is breaking through before the year comes to an end. Somebody is buying a property, building your house, fulfilling your destiny. I'm speaking to everyone that believe in God's word. The word of God is a supernatural key. He's a master key. He's a golden key. I prophesy somebody is breaking through by the level of your revelation. You are breaking through by the level of your revelation. You are building your house. You are out of nothing. Out of nothing, something will come out. Because you have what it takes to manifest what you have not seen with your physical eye. And that is the word of God. I speak it to somebody here. Whether the devil like it or not, you are fulfilling your destiny this year. Lift your two hands and shout the loudest amen. No way, shout it again. No way, shout it again. I didn't hear your voice. Let your enemy come like a thunder. mighty clap of it. Do it better. Do it better. Do it better. The enemy couldn't handle Jesus because he kept God's word. It was the same enemy that caused damage to Adam and Eve. It was the same enemy who caused damage to them, who took them from level of God's realm. They took them from the class of God into the class of man. Do you hear what I was saying? The enemy, it was the same enemy who deceived Adam and Eve, removing them from the class of God into the class of men. And Jesus maintained his class, his level. Jesus maintained the same level. Oh my God. We are graduating. We are graduating. So the level of revelation determined by how you will be ushered into the next stage of your life. Everyone in the eyes of the enemy and in the eyes of God, without God's word, is like a blind person. Oh gosh. Praise God. Can I repeat? Can I make a revelation? Let me make the revelation. I said it before. That the word of God is a career of the wonders of God. Write it. If you believe in writing. Write it. Keep it in your spirit. Today I came to preach you. The word of God is a vehicle that carries the wonders of God. The word of God is a supernatural vehicle that carries the wonders of God. Yeah, baby, nyanko pansem ye active will be a miracle. Flow, signs, wonders, testimonies. I don't have to see an enemy bowing to you and saying, my God, you say, my wish you fear for me. By the level of your revelation, you receive every enemy bow down. And you're automatic. And you're automatic. Me the witch in Anna, me show, come, say, my wish you fear for me. You are living without revelation. Hold on to this master key. Witches and wizards will come and bow down to you and they will confess to you. Give God another clap offering. We are not to struggle. We are not to struggle. We are not to struggle. In this life, we are not to struggle. Praise God. Adam was chased out of the Garden of Eden. And it became a curse because he couldn't maintain his stature. Wow, is that how you are looking at me? I'm telling you what you are going to be, and you are looking at me. I see you are buying, you are paying for the amen. I see you are paying for the amen. Or you still want to remain poor?
You still want to remain beggar? Hey.
Psalm 119, verse 18. If this creature can't change your life, praise God. Oh, I say praise God. I say praise God. I say praise God. Look at what David said. He said, open thou my eyes. That's the prayer of David. That's the prayer of David. He said, open thou my eyes that I may behold the wondrous thing out of thy law.
John says, "Na kame kese pa na mihadi." They be tiamo dem pa. But John says, "Koshona kame kese pa."
This is appetite. Cultivating appetite for revelation that can take you to the next stage of your life. Growing your level of appetite. You see, in this church, I have seen that appetite for God's word is what many people lack. Praise God. People come to church and they are very late. As a senior pastor, you start preaching before they come. And when they come, maybe you are about, sorry, 15 minutes to end the service. Are you mad? Are you crazy? Open. Look. Let me tell you something. We are not talking about this physical eyes. Praise God. I'm not talking about this physical eye. He said, open my eyes. Be a many one kushia. Ne mean to me awa dear nsenchre near if you was a muba. So nyankopwa sem is a vehicle. It carried the wonders. There's a miracle in the word. There's a breakthrough in the word. I'm talking the revelation you receive and you couldn't even write it and put it in your spirit. Your revelation, the next stage of your life is inside that revelation. You threw it away. You threw it anyhow. That is why you lack the ability to move to the next stage of your life. Oh God, I see God putting somebody's life.
I was preaching some years back, and a young man was about to travel. The guy has a visa. Was about to travel. And he said, "Pastor, based on the thing you are talking about, I'm not traveling anymore. I won't even go." A young man has a visa, wanted to travel. And I was preaching about how God blesses his people. He said, "Pastor, based on what you are talking about, the revelation, the blessings of God has nothing to do with the geographical location." And he said, "Let me live here. I'll be blessed." And within shortest time, he was lifted up. And you say promo, and you say we boss from promo too. And you say on first, you can't even count with salary. Ain't it a brabo, yes, sir? And your lack of revelation, you have not received. Look, I am telling you, By the time you may be paid and sabbat, whatever you are changing will begin to change you. I don't love the way you responded to it. Lift your right hand, every one of you responded. Love the love this, amen. You are like a blind. Even when you are closer to miracle, you cannot tap into the miracle. Even when you are closer to your marriage, you cannot tap into the marriage. Even when you are living with a good woman, with a good man, you cannot see because you are a blind person. Should I continue or I should stop? Minyai. Mentuaso. And I must be very free also. Okay. And I'm from myself and free also. And the pedans and a bon sem kasipa and I can't make a sipa my Yesu. Myself, you are like a blind person without revelation. In Crawford, Qua won't go be that. Crawford, but won't be that. You will become like a liability without revelation. Praise God. Everyone without revelation is like a fool. So ask him, shall we? Ebeya save. These are things you have to save at your WhatsApp status and on the wall of your Facebook. Not only when you are celebrating your birthday. Give the Lord another clap of it. Psalm 107, verse 17. Let me make a declaration that beginning from today, the enemy will never take you for granted anymore. Look at it. Look at it. Look at it. Then we pray. He said, fools, because of their transgression, fools. And I hope shall to fools as it. Auntie, we'll read Bible. Where be? Can fools, you know what I'm reading? Tree in the canon. Ajajin tree. In other tree Bible, 77 kwasi afuo. Mina me ade 7. God nyankopon, he own anyone's apology. But I am standing before my colleague, human being, my fellow human being. But anyway, I'm not talking to you, I'm talking to the fools. Because of their own transgression, look at it. And because of their iniquity, they are afflicted. Did you hear what? Did you hear that one? They have been afflicted out of foolishness and iniquity. They have been afflicted. The enemy is playing their destiny like chess killing. because of foolishness. It is sometimes you must be responsible for your own predicament. Based on this scripture. In fact, how we should be keep it. Verse 18. Look at it. They are so abhor all manner of meat because of foolishness. And they draw, now hear this one, because of foolishness, and they draw near unto the gate of death out of your own foolishness. Are you there? They draw near unto where? If you are here and you are getting closer, you are getting closer to the gate of death. By revel of revelation, I declare that you are walking out of that gate. May the revelation of God reorder your step into a life full of good pleasure. Lift your two hands and shout the loudest amen. I'm preaching good, though. I'm preaching good. Sometimes you look at life, you look around all your life, and this one is dead. Everything is dead. Everything around you dying from one to another. Then know, you have to know that something is missing somewhere. Praise God. They draw near unto the gate of death. Verse 19. Then they came back to their senses. Then they cry unto the Lord their God in trouble. The same people. Because they realized that everything is going from west to west. Then they cried unto God. They prayed unto God. They fasted unto God. Hello there. Hello. Peter said, come in. I'm here. They cried unto God. Exactly what we are doing. And the Lord saved them out of their distress. He's a merciful God. Then, to maintain what God has done for their life, look at the next stage. Verse 20. Then he sent his word. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from all their. Can I hear another amen? Everything around them have been died. They are on their way to distraction, confusion, and everything. They cried unto God. God answered their prayer. He saved them. And for them to be able to keep what God has given to them, God sent them a word. The word of God is a means to preserve what God has delivered into their hands. To keep your standard, your stature, your healing, your deliverance, your blessing, your gift, the anointing. You need a revelation. Give the Lord a mighty clap offering. Do it better. to remain as foolish. We are children of the Most High God. We are children of the Most High God. We are not to walk as foolish fools. Fools because of their own transgression. They are suffering. They cried unto God out of. The Lord saved them and delivered them. God gave them a word to keep. You are to keep. You are to keep what God has given to you by the level of revelation. And they say, Yankupon Shirawa, you can only keep what God is going to deliver into your hand by level. You see, the more you receive the revelation, the more the blessings are being expanded. Yes. Go to the book of Proverbs chapter 1. Maybe you see here. Proverbs chapter 1. Verse 22 and 23. Look at it. Look at it. No. Me ba chobe country Bible na mami why? Anti obe country na mami. Look at it. Let's read it. One, two, go. How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their own scorning, and fools. Hey, and now sorry, I'll buy you one. And now, but count yourself blessed. If you are not careful, you will not understand the word simple and simplicity. Read it from the Tree Bible. Read it. Come. Because we have a way of understand of simple and simplicity. But the Tree Bible explains it more. Or see there.
That the
Bible says you can't tree because you can't. So be at the choir. What you say? I say and say. Chifot chinibia ni obetimi ami edikom. Ye kas obi atetekwa ni ase ne sey. Wo ye deni. Wo ya santini. Ye kas obi atetekwa ni ase ne sey. Obi anani muye. Obi ye kurasi ni. Obi a. Obi anu shu ni mfaso. Obi oye useless. Transier.
That Ben Namonte to choir, Muba Pet and Tetuqua Sem Akosi.
In other words, Mu Sabi Sabin Kwasia for in Kwasia for. Or see, how long are you ready to graduate? I say, it's a week of graduation. You can't afford to remain. As a simple and simplicity, wait. So I say, "Ain't you told me a Jimmy and Cha? In you me? I don't want to wear Jimmy. Praise God! Are you ready to graduate? How long?
That Ben Amonte to kwa, mu be pente to kwa." Sem akosi na afewdi fo bepe won fewdi na nkwasea echi nimdie
na nkwasea ye de ben
echi nimdie
obi o ye sebe kwasea bi ochi de ben ochi nimdie obi o mo brechi nimdie yes sit down obi o mo bre bia ochi nimdie on partner atene on person be correct no on person be twin anim on person be catch sense adi we are here on ko onipa do oni be be akọ ontimi onim ade ya friend change or ye omini knowers leading to foolishness and stupidity. Praise God. You see, let me tell you, and they will be coming to be sure make catch sense adi where you did it wrong. You need courage and humility to accept. A question that God is asking, how long will you love simplicity?
No change. How long? The hour has come. You didn't hear what I said. I said the hour has come. It's a week of graduation. You are moving from one stage into another. You can't afford to be like a foolish person. Hey, you are a daughter of the Most High God. You are a son of the Most High God. Come on, shout yes. How long will you repeat your mistakes? How long will you repeat the same thing that destroyed your life and career? How can you be connected to something that is destroying your life? Can I preach? How long? The same thing that destroys you, the same thing that destroys you, have become addicted. Praise God. Am I preaching at all? Praise God. Why do you want to be addicted? Why do you tie your soul with something that destroys you? That's what it means. And say fools love knowledge, they hate knowledge. That's the reason why you must be at church on time. Before the pastor laid the foundation of the preaching, you are already there. Praise God. Tapping into the revelation, writing some of the revelation down. Praise God. Keeping the revelation in your spirit. Fools hate knowledge. Black 23. Maybe. I'll preach it again. This message. I'll preach it once again. 23. Let's read it. One to go. Turn you at my reproof. 10. If I had to lift yourself up and change your level, you have to turn from being foolish. It means you will be corrected. There will be a Bible study, be preaching man once so sir, will be a new attempt. Once there be a Bible study, preach it as will be a canvas man, will be a canvas man. Any of them or software brobe, a war. Will be a canvas man. So he will speak to his servant to preach about it. Praise God. He will speak to his servant. Turn you out. Turn you at my reproof. And hear this. And say, behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. God is waiting for a day that you will change your life. You will change your calamity the Azawa way. Then you will drop his anointing on your life. Adon Satan. While I'm talking to somebody, God said, I'm waiting for the day that you receive instruction and you will change your mind and improve yourself. Then I will release my spirit upon you. Shout yes. Shout yes. Shout yes. God is waiting for the day you will change your mind and you will pour the anointing. You think the anointing will come. How can God pour a new wine into an old bottle? Isn't it a scripture like that? The new wine are not supposed to pour it into an old bottle. Do you know that? Or you don't know? Then I'm telling you, the Almighty God is not going to pour his new wine into your old bottle Everyone here represents a bottle. You are like a bottle. You are like a container that carries the Spirit of God. As long as you remain old and you are not transforming, you are not supposed to go forward. Turn to my reproof. There are many of you, you are to receive the double of whatever I carry on this altar. But God is waiting for the day that you will change and be transformed by the renewal of your mind. Then you will carry the same. I pray for everyone that is ready to change. I decree and I declare, may you carry the supernatural. May you carry the apostolic. May you carry the prophetic. May you carry the favor. May you be accepted. May you be loved. May you be lifted up. Shout yes. Shout yes. Shout yes. Shout yes. A little volume, man. Are you enjoying yourself? No, am I preaching well? Yes. Be not be conformed to this world, but be ye what? Transformed by the renewing. As long as you still keep the old mentality, your appearance is a confuse. Everything around you is a confuse. Praise God. You see, let me tell you, in this life, you do not desire to become. Praise God. I desire to become like apostle. It is good to desire, but there is a way. Praise God. There is a way. There is. You don't just wish. Something must be changed. Certain steps must be taken. Hallelujah. Yes. Change it, change it, change it. How long? 23, 23, 23. Tell you at my reproof. And I will pour out my spirit unto you. Hear this. And I will make known my words unto you. It's a graduation. Praise God. So you have a part to play. You have, in connection to your own destiny, you have a part to play. Praise God. If you are, listen, if you are to catch God's attention, if you are to catch God's attention, then you have to do something extraordinary. If you are to catch God's attention, you must do something extraordinary. That is you. Number one, turn at my reproof. And God said, as you do that, I will pour my spirit. I'll pour my spirit unto you. And he said, secondly, then I will make known. That is when the miracle will start coming. The blessings will start coming. The breakthroughs are coming. The marriages will start coming. The doors begin to open. Destiny that was locked, recovered. I'm talking to somebody here. As long as you remain dead, you remain dead as a blind, you have no asset. Change your mind. So the way to the top, I'll preach part two of this message coming Friday. The way to the door is in the revelation you received. As I conclude, Psalm 103, verse 6.
Nyami kokro kousu wunu kwari etim eche yebe
verse 7
obobo yebe 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 yebe.
Oh yes Lord. So look at the standard. Look at it. The Holy Spirit wants to do something in the life of somebody here. Look at it. He made known his way unto who? What is the way? What do I mean by he made? Or what do God mean by he made his ways known to every destination? There are ways. There's a way that leads to Kumasi. It's not the same way that leads to Kumasi. It's the same way that leads to Volta region. Or leads to mountains, or central region, or western region. Anamibwa. Anamusede. He did what? He made his way
Know unto who? Read it one to go. And you know the difference between the acts and the ways. Wouldn't it be? Without the ways, there will be no properly release of the acts. Because it is the way that leads to the act, the action. We are talking about the act, the action. The act is the move of God. The action, the miracle, the signs, the wonder, the miracle, the breakthrough. So you see, the reason why Moses always keeps his level is because he knew the ways. Amen. He knows the ways to open the Red Sea. What the children of Israel are always looking at is the action side. Now your partner said, a man out to young cousin in Shraba, in Shraba, young conum. They're always waiting for the action. But the way to the act or the action is the word of God.